Hello everybody and welcome to the next episode in Jack Wall Let's Play Train Simulator 2014. I'm still developing in my career. I have a long way to go, but it seems that I have increased my level to number 5. I'm on route to 6. And I seem to have picked up some achievements along the way as well. This is done the whole journey, Far Horizons. Completed all career scenarios. Anyway, I'll just flick through those and you can read them yourselves. So, let's jump in and see what we're going to do today. Well, we've kind of completed that. There's a Lower Saxony regional stopper. I don't really know an awful lot about this. It looks like that might be a freight train, diesel dock train. Those things look cool. Down by the docks in Vienna, they have a few of those. These look like they're all American jobs, so I won't try those. And I have this red X down here that is somewhat annoying me. But I'm not truly convinced that I'm ready for that yet. This is freight, that's an intercity, it's 85 minutes, might make for a long two-parter, I suppose. Yeah, or we could do this intercity, drive the ICE2, drive the ICE2, during a storm with heavy rain, keeping an eye on the signals as they are held up by the train ahead. So that sounds kind of a little bit like the last one. Yeah. This is 85 minutes, and I think maybe we'll have a go at this. He says. In we go. Too late now. We've started. So I'll bring... Well, here we are. The pantograph has come up. We are, by the looks of things, we are... Okay, well, we're there. Let's open the doors, begin that process. Oh, I've just gone underneath the platform there. This morning you will have station stops at Harburg, Lüneburg, Ulsen, and Sellel, before finishing your job at the Hanover station. Open the doors and let the passengers in. Right, well, we're progressing quite nicely. Our departure is at 10, which is now, and our arrival is 10 past 10 at the next station. So, we are about to depart now, which is what we're doing. Hop into the cab, and we're going to proceed to Harburg. Now, it's a 40 speed limit here, so we shall run at 40, turn on those cab lights. I love the hum of these electrics. In the middle of Vienna, there's the same sounds that you can hear from outside the train as well. It's pretty realistic. So out we go. Concentrate on this one, and it's yeah, it's good. So our intention here is to stop at Harbor Gleis 4, and this is Hamburg, so we've got to go through here, I think, right? Oh, Gleis 13, so... Yeah. Yeah, I think we just fly through here. I don't believe we have to stop. Let me get this right now. Harburg, not Hamburg. Yeah. Okay, yeah. we're going to pass underneath it or nearby, so we can run this one up a little bit. We have a little bit of a bit of room to turn. Ooh, passenger comfort is just a little bit on the... Need to bring it back in. At least we're coming off this curve now, so we're okay. And it's spitting with a little bit of rain. Nothing too serious. So just bring down the acceleration there to let it just cruise along here now. We do have 120 coming up, and we're not too far away from that, so that's not too bad. We are kind of upsetting our passengers a little bit though, we're right on the edge. And I'm accelerating. Need to just bring that back a little bit. And I went into speeding as well. I thought I was using the brake. I think I'm still in that other train. Okay, so centrifugal force, they were a little pushed over there, but nothing too bad. Now we can open her up a little bit. Get some speed under us. And we have 6 more minutes to travel the 9 kilometers, so... I'm going to get hosed again. I've lost everything that I gained. 198 points lost for speeding. God almighty. It just goes to show that I haven't really learned all that much, have I? You almost need to have 2 or 3 views when you record it. You can, when you're playing back your own recording, you can play it back from in the cab or outside. Now I can do 120, it says. Pretty good acceleration this train. Williamsburg. Right, so I'm minus 35 points and I haven't even got to the first station because I was trying to get all fancy. Turn that off now because I don't think there's enough rain to warrant it. We're just wearing rubber. And we are bringing ourselves up to full speed here now. And we'll give ourselves 13% just to keep ticking along. And we have 100 warning coming up ahead. There's very little indication on the controls here on when there's a speed change approaching. I would have thought that that would have been the case. I suppose I better start putting in a little bit of brake now because I need to come down to 100. So 17% will bring down the speed a little bit as I go along, but not too much too quickly. Otherwise we'll lose too much time. 3.6 kilometers to go. We're not really dropping any speed at all now, but I've just put in a little bit. Got 30 to go down. Need to add a little bit more. Get it down into the teens. At half a mile. That's okay. So I think I shall just apply a little bit of relaxed brake there now, and that just brings me down. Just nicely. We don't want to go too far down. And this is Harbour Glacier. So we do need to start applying gentle brake here now. At that rate. And we are arriving at 10:10, so... We still have 2 kilometers to go, so there's no need to be too worried. But we do have to look out for speed restrictions on the line, because we really can't afford to speed anymore. One of these days, folks, I'll eventually learn to do a near perfect run, but that's not going to be anytime soon. 1.3 kilometers. I'm just accelerated again. It's funny how you get used to one set of controls and then you have to learn how to get through to others. I think I didn't turn down my volume on this recording, so apologies for the noise. And if it sounds like I'm shouting into the microphone, I will pop out and do something about that. Well, there's no speeding fines for coming in at this speed. And Jesus, that horn is terrible. Really? 47 that's coming in there, I do need to apply a little bit more brake now. Because I'm on station, and I'm 30. I'm not going to run off the platform or anything, it's just people are going to have to walk a little bit to get to me. Which may be a little bit less than ideal. Yeah, you see they're all walking up from behind there. But and all these people are going to have to walk the long way back down as well. But anyway. That's what it is. Our departure is 10:10. And our pickup is in Lüneburg at 10:27. So, we can set that to zero, I suppose. Put our brake on at 100% for safety, I suppose. And, day running and everything is fine. Successful stop. We can take off the brake, select forward, and engage. Proceed to Lüneburg. Everybody is aboard, and off we go. Now it's giving me 120 speed limits straight off the bat. Of course I'm not going to be able to instantly do 120 kilometers per hour, but you wonder, don't you? I think we'll just pull out at a nice speed from there, and consider that okay, and we can start getting up the speed. Time-wise estimated, I seem to be okay at the moment. Let's see how that goes. I have 37 kilometers to go, so I have a good bit to go, really. And our map is basically a straight line for most of it. Right, well, we're ramping up here quite nicely. You kind of lose the you lose the power pretty much instantaneously when you drop the potentiometer here. That'll do us. I think 119, 120 is a fairly decent speed setting to set at. Hopefully we can keep that. I'm just knocking it back a little bit because I'd really like that next number to be 119 and not 121. And it is 121, look at that. Now we're back to 19, so that's okay. a bit loud as we go through those tunnels. Hit the Q to keep the AWS system happy. And we're watching for the 160 speed limit that we can utilize. And I believe that that's good to go now. So. So, at least we recouped some of our lost points, but we should be much better off, of course, with experience points than we are, all because Jack didn't know how to... follow the rules. Head out the window. It's crazy, isn't it? At 160 kilometers an hour. I don't think it's the greatest idea in the whole world. Okay. Now it is reporting 160 on the thingy here, which is interesting, and it's got a blue marker, so I've only just noticed that now. The rest of you have been saying, it's over there, you blind word of own choice. Idiot, would be mine. It's not very nice to call someone an idiot. It's perfectly okay to call yourself an idiot, in my books. So, yeah, here it is reporting the 160, so I guess I could follow that. I wouldn't need this console too much. We still have 30 kilometers to go at 160. We could probably edge this ever so slightly with a few more amps. But there we go, heading past the countryside. All nice, and really the view out the window isn't bad at all, is it? Those trees are pretty good. The brush and the ground plants and the weeds and leaves and everything are not bad at all. A spot of rain coming. And we're on it. 159 rising 160. 28 kilometers to go, and feel like we have a bit of control here. We're meeting ourselves on the way back. Just want to bring that to 21% now. And okay, so 27 was too much, so 22 or 23 might hold it. Need to put in an input to counteract the air resistance of traveling at the speed plus whatever resistance is in the rail. That's 200 amps, which is not very much in the big scheme of things, but this is quite a bit just for steady state running. But then we're not talking about a little small train here, are we? 26 kilometers to go and all appears normal. This screen here is quite useful because it gives you your throttle positioning and your brake positioning. What is that for? That's for headlights. Turn those on, I suppose. This here is the train brake. This here is nothing. That is the speed pre-select. Speed pre-select.
RFB. RFB.
I don't know what that is. I don't know what it means. I'll have to look up that. RFB. Some autofahrtbahn or something, some automatic control. Schlapping it up. What is written there? Ah, so there are pre-selects, so it is kind of your, consider it to be your automatic control, like an autopilot in a plane. Hmm. Thank check you for that morning. Everything is good. We are accelerating to 200 by choice. We'll leave the wiper on. Okay, but this is a warning for I'm not sure what. What is that warning for? G. That's brilliant. I'm speeding. Oh no, 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 I'm losing stupid amounts of points. What the hell? What happened? Oh no. Freaking hell. I guess I worked out what that G meant then, and it gave me plenty of warning with the sound signal. But I didn't know what it meant. Well, look at the score. I've lost 700 points. Bloody hell. And everything was going so average. Ah, God. I don't know if I have enough stations to be able to get on time enough to make enough points to cover up. I've got to redress 538 points to get back on the station to earn anything from this. Now I do have a 160 coming up and I can see that, but I didn't see... I wasn't watching that screen, maybe. Puck. Puck. With a P. Yes, it's not very clever, you know what I mean. Okay, that's the warning to say, hey, dude, you are coming into a slower section. So we can knock that off and we can start adding in some gentle brake. Make sure we don't spill any Pepsi or Coke or whatever on our passengers. I need to turn you off. I am slowing down. I've done my slowing down. It's a 160 and I'm comfortably under. So, no speed in here. It's a bit annoying, isn't it? Because it tells me that there's a 200 coming up. So I can... Oh, I don't understand. Alrighty. Well, we haven't incurred any more speeding. We have green lights on the trail. We are accelerating just a bit nicely, and we're at 200, so let's use what we can, when we can. And whatever this place is, this Radbruck, which is this bridge here, we are spooling under it. Red lights, but we are green on our rail. Just for the ladies. Okay, so that red light is telling me that there's a speed change up ahead. I told you at the very start we're learning this as we're going along. This is not pretty. Later episodes we will be more proficient and we will know what we're doing, but I that includes concentrating it a little bit more than this run is. How the hell am I going to get back these points? Forget about it. I'm not going to try and worry. Let's keep our passengers comfortable and have them off the train in the same fashion that they've stepped on. Perhaps a little impressed at being at their destination just on time. I think I'll go for the public vote. I'll never keep it under 600 for this run, will I? Yes, I can. It's all about the right attitude. I got it. We're sticking the brake on a little. We're bringing her down. We've only got 12 to go. Ain't no problem. We'll just let it run out on friction. And we should be F-I-N-E. This is Barrowick 102. There we are, on station 160. AWS is off. I'm 159. Now it says 200 you see here, and that's a lie, because it's not a 200. I can see everywhere else it's 160. So it's just trying to get you in trouble, this machine. Now it's back to 160 because it realizes its mistake.
Alarm!
What a silly horn. You can never trust it, can you? I wish I could use it as an excuse for my ridiculously bad quality of play, but who would I be fooling? We'll get there, though. We will. Right, 200 is about to present itself. Red number 160, change to 110. It's 110. It says 200 on there. I don't believe this HUD at all. I prefer to believe this. I'm going to slow it down gently. Oh, at 110, I don't believe that either. I think it's just trying to get me late. Arrival at 127, 3 kilometers to go. It says 200 up there though. 110 is the slowest speed ahead. Wie soll wie ist. Okay. So yellow is what I am, and red is what I shall be. So I shall be down to 110, and I am going to be able to do that quite comfortably. Yes, 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 you will notice that I am 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I'm on station, or I'm on speed mark. So that's good. Now we do need to roll it in. We still have 1.7 kilometers to go, so slowing down too quickly is only going to delay our arrival, and we are looking good in terms of time. Coming onto station now within a kilometer. Our arrival will be quite okay. And we are at 93 within 0.8. I shall start to apply ever so slight brake just to kind of get it. We have a fairly, it's not a big place here, but this is the platform that we're coming onto. So we are coming on quite strong here at 80, so I shall start to apply fairly decent brake here now. At 70, I shall have to apply a little bit more. 66% brake. 55, holy cow. 100% brake. We are going to not stop on time, are we?
Whoa.
That was, I think, right on the limit. I can't move the camera around well enough, but that's what I wanted to show. Okay. Well, not... We'll call that arrived, shall we? And say no more. We are arriving... We're arrived on time at plenty of time, so I don't know if it's really going to do much for us in terms of our timeliness score, but we are to leave 27 minutes past with a 43-minute arrival at Weizen, or however you pronounce that, Weizen Gleis. Ui. Eisen is E-I, so Ueisen, so Weizen Gleis. Ein Null. 101. Okay, Heinz. We'll select forward. Train successfully stopped. 167, so it's not exactly enough to really recover from the disaster of my speed tracking, but it'll help. Full whack. We'll just roll through here. So 110 is quoted. And we will plow through that without any braking. Alrighty then, so 160 is quoted. We will have to stabilize before we get to the 200. We have 60 more to go as of now. Although at this rate of climb, we may not have to brake at all. 50 to go. 1.3 kilometers. Should I start to bring down the red handle a little bit, I wonder? 35 to go. To go. I think we won't have to touch it. I think it'll just... the 200 limit is set exactly where it needs to be for this train at this time. Yeah, so there's the traffic lights on. The 200 is just a little part of the damn track. And we're not going to be anywhere near the 160, breaking the speed limit by the time we get there. We'll just be on it, though. Yes, hello, why are you beeping? 140 coming up. So I shall start to bring her back down gently. Don't need to overdo it. We are 1.5 miles away, and this speed limit is in the middle of Deutsche Bahn plans. So I think 130 is more than enough headroom on the speed. 143 is our schedule, 141 is our estimated, 129, 58, 59, 1030 is my, start that again, 1043 is my scheduled, 1041 is my estimated, and 1030 is my actual time. So we're up into the two, you see, are we? We're not. That was telling me 200 there again, but I know now not to trust it. 200 is coming up, but it's in the future. 1.5 kilometers in the future. No, as they say in certain parts of the world. I think we can roll up to this. Those, they're not real lights, they're just track indicators. They are real lights, but they're not like the traffic lights that are coming up ahead of us. 140 reported, should switch to 200 any second. Now 160 it's calling, not 200. Well, that's a mismatch again. This is calling 200, the red is saying 200, but the planned speed is 160, because, okay, maybe the 160 is telling me that that's what the speed limit is up ahead, the next formal speed limit after the last one. Yeah, yeah it is, because it's velocity shall, sol, even. So I can go up higher if I want. But I do have to realize that I can't go much more than 160, because I would need to come back down to 160, so... yeah. Yeah. Let's bring it back down. 160 is about there, so that's good. We'll cancel the AWS if that's what that A sound was. I think it was just a warning sound, though, to say 160 is coming. Now, that 160 should go to 200, but in fact it goes to 140. Because there's a 140 further down the food chain. So, I don't think I have to do the 140 just yet. I can actually do one. This is saying 160, the screen on the bottom is saying 200. It's a lottery. I know there's a 140 coming up from two sources, so I'm going to go with that. And I should expect to hear a sound any minute now. By way of gentle reminder that we need to slow down to 140, which we're at, and we can roll at that. I think 20% should be enough to... maybe 22 or 3 will be enough to run. Now it says I can do 200, but... actually, that's just going to drop to 140 now, of course. Which was the plan all along, and we're not stopping here. Is that train station, like, a little bit missed on the... Okay. On 140, we'll just take a little bit of the heat off of that. And we go to Bienenbüttel. B und A. Super. Duper. Okay, some straw bales over there in the field. And some kind of a parking spot beside a factory or something. Yeah, the scenery out the window, not that I get too much time to look at it, to be honest with you, because we tend to be pretty much occupied with what's inside. Now, is this going to tell me that 200 is allowable or doable? I still have 20 kilometers to go. I could do with sending it down a little faster. 421 negative points. God. Right. So I'm passing the 200 on the marker here. 160 is offered. As the next one, 200 is possible to do, and we'll bring it up now to above 160 anyway. We'll do 175, 180 perhaps. And get ourselves... we have a little bit of an incline, it looks like, as well. Not much, but just a little. And we have Irish rain falling out of a pretty much a blue sky. Yeah, there's the 160 that it's warning me about, so... probably we'll hold it off at 180, that's fast enough. Might have to throw in a little bit of brake here. I suppose the real trick is not to use too much brake. Warning received, warning received, warning received. 170, that's 10 over, and I'm going to lose it on this little incline, so I think that'll just be about right. There's the traffic lights, and I still have a kilometer to go. Ah, yes, gotcha. Pressing Q like a madman here. Just past the traffic lights. And we are just at the 160, so I shall apply a little bit of juice. Keep it at the 160, we have a 140 coming up. Yes. Green lights are all good. Now we have leveled off a little bit here. Still at 14 kilometers to go. We're 18 over the next speed limit section. 17 now. Let's just zero out that and see what we drop down. 1.5 kilometers to go to lose 15 kilometers per hour. Yeah. Probably going to be able to do that, just about. Traffic lights, and then it's about 800 meters. Less than that, 500 meters. Yes. Probably not slowing enough. We're going to add in a little bit here. Now it's telling me 160, but I don't believe that either. We're at the 140, which is where we need to be. And we have a bit of a turn coming up, so that's probably part of the reason for that speed. Alrighty then. Still have 11.5 kilometers to go, so... Could do it, getting a giddy up here. I'm my estimated is just right on my schedule. We have 7, 6, 5, what have we got? We've got 5 minutes as of now with which to do it, so we have a 200 coming up here, which is decent. Hopefully we get a bit of a run out of the 200 and knock off a lot of this 10 kilometers. Now it is a 140 here, so I can't accelerate too early, and I still have 1.8 kilometers before I can start to accelerate, so... And if I accelerate beforehand, the game will say you're very bad. Petty dang thing. That's us driving through the countryside. Which is not too bad. Windscreen wipers on a go. You can see the lights as well, she's holding out. Yeah, it's nice, decent view outside, isn't it? Right, well, the 200 is coming up here. Mind your heads. Ooh. And, I believe... we can do a little bit more on the speed, but we can't really do an awful lot, because within a kilometer and a half... excuse me, within a kilometer now there's a 140 again, so... yeah. Q, Q, Q. Okay, I'm alive. I'm kicking. Or 15%. We don't really want to go too much below the 140. Ah, Lord. It is crazy. It's Christopher Walken. It's crazy. How about that for the worst impression of Christopher Walken that you've heard today? You should go onto the web and find a decent impression of him straight away just to, you know, square yourself. Got a 160 coming up again, but this is pretty painful. We have covered most of the... we've covered most of 5 kilometers out of that 10. So we are making progress, but we're slipping a little bit on the time. Our estimated now is brought up to 43:29 past, and our actual is 2.5 minutes away from the 43rd minute. So we're there or thereabouts. We're okay, but we don't really have anything in the bag apart from a bag full of negative points or canal points.